in this illustration, we'll study the measurement of surface tension by coalescing bubbles. We are given that under isothermal conditions, two soap bubbles of radii A and B coalesce to form a single bubble of radius C. We are given that atmospheric pressure to be P0, we are required to find the surface tension of this soap bubble. Now, in this situation, we can see, one, the two bubbles of radii A and B coalesce. We can consider total moles of air in the bubbles remain conserved, as we are assuming the bubbles are coalescing to form a new bubble and total amount of air remain constant, so total moles of air remain conserved. This implies we can write by gas law, we use P1V1 by T1 plus P2V2 by T2 is equals to P3V3 by T3. If this is for first bubble, this is for second bubble, and this is after coalescing the third bubble. At temperature we can cancel, as we are given that T1 equals to T2 equals to T3 under isothermal conditions. So, in this situation, we can write the initial pressure of first bubble can be given as P0 plus 4T by A. This is the initial pressure of the first bubble multiplied by its volume. We can write as 4 by 3 pi A cube, plus initial pressure of the second bubble. We can write P0 plus 4T by B. Multiplied by its volume will be 4 by 3 pi B cube, and this must be equals to, for the final bubble as its radius is C, we can write its final pressure to be P0 plus 4T by C multiplied by 4 by 3 pi C cube. And if we simplify this relation here, 4 by 3 pi gets cancelled out. And simplifying, this is giving us the value of T. We can simply write, simplifying this relation, we get the value of T is equals to P0 multiplied by C cube minus A cube minus B cube divided by 4 times A square plus B square minus C square. That is the result of this problem.